We're in the Mississippi Delta to see what's new with black bear research.
Should I ask to confirm, make sure you didn't hit the wrong button. Hit the button.
So in 2007, the first documented set of Louisiana black bears born in the Mississippi Delta in right at 40 years, I think, were born on our farm. And so that began our education with the bears. As we opened our farm up to U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries and Parks, Mississippi State University, and others to come in and do research. And over the next 5 or 7 years thereabouts, we had the opportunity to run den checks and bait sites where we captured bears throughout the year. It's just been a phenomenal run, phenomenal education, having it fall in our lap like that and then being able to interact with the biologist and learn as much as we have been able to learn about these bears.
We're over here in the South Delta. And one of the first things we're doing is running a camera survey for bears. This is an area of known bear occupancy. Landowners have sent us photographs, trail cam pictures, have worked with us in the past on trapping and radio collaring bears. Okay, we set up these cameras 9 days ago. Got the survey started. We're coming back to check the cards and check the SD cards. We'll swap them out with new cards, and also we'll put some fresh lure out. Working with us today, Jamie Holt is the black bear biologist. Jamie moved over from our South Delta WMA program. He's now the black bear program biologist, and he's the one doing the fun works, pouring out the sweet stuff to hopefully attract a bear.
The biggest thing we're trying to do is get more of an idea of where, in areas that we know we've got bears, and try to figure out how dense they are in those areas. And we're also kind of monitoring how they're moving into areas that we haven't normally found them, and they most definitely are. We're seeing females start to move and breed in further east than we've ever seen them before. So they are out and moving, and we're just trying to get an idea and document how that movement's taking place and how fast it's moving and where they're going to, and you know, what kind of habitat are they coming out of and what kind of habitats are they moving into. We're using a liquid attractant, about 3 different kinds. And the reason we're using this as opposed to something like corn is for to give a little more long lasting effect.
These heavy liquids are pouring on logs and things, and there's also grubs and different kinds of invertebrates in these logs that bears will eat. And we've got a spray liquid attractant. It's a real strong berry smell, and we're spraying it kind of up high to get their attention, and maybe they'll come up and stand up on these trees and check that out. They're pretty curious animals. Give them a few different opportunities to show up and reasons to hang around for a few minutes and have a picture taken.
All the way down, let's kind of keep the noise and racket to a, you know, to a minimum. This female is a runner. She has a history of running, but this is the first time she's had cubs that we know of. When Jamie and Roger and I were over here the other day and found the den, Jamie literally almost stepped on her. And we heard cubs, so we know she has at least one cub. So that maternal instinct hopefully is gonna keep her right there. Still, we need to keep any kind of noise and everything to a minimum until we get her darted and sedated. And then Jamie and Roger and I will go from there over to the den, hopefully sedate her, dart her, watch her. Once she is immobilized or sedate, we'll signal to y'all, come on in. Thank you. A few bears have hung out here over the years, but what has happened in recent years, I say recent, the last 10 to 15 years, bear populations in adjacent Arkansas and adjacent Louisiana have expanded. They actually will swim the Mississippi River. We know that from radio collared bears. And what's happened here is that females have come. They bred with males that have occurred in Mississippi, and so now this population is growing. For many years, we pretty much just had males up through here. So really, this area is, I guess, kind of exploding with bears now. And we're looking to see, looking at habitat, what is here that the bears like.
Oh, he's getting down in the water.
Yeah, so I'm playing that.
What's that little buddy? Uh-oh, you ran your mama off. Come on up here. Come on up here, little buddy. Come on. Come on. I know. Start opening up that green pack there.
You'll put it in a separate envelope?
Oh, let's do the... Yes, we'll, I'm going to be putting it in.
Hand me another one, I'll fill it out.
I'll be putting it in a vial.
Oh, okay.
Here with alcohol. Where's my pack? Front pad length is 12.5.
So she left here and made a big loop through the woods.
Probably.
And came back out and went
mile to three quarters of a mile down there. Straight shot.
Well, she's right, she's a runner.
She's holding up her reputation.
I think the bears have a wonderful future in the state of Mississippi. Again, suitable habitat, and I think the habitat here is suitable for them, and it's providing for their needs year round. And the research that's being done is tremendous. I've thoroughly enjoyed participating in it. And I think the cooperation between the landowners, the agency has been good, and needs to continue. It's science. It's very good stuff.